my mama call, see you on TV, sunset shit done change.
Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm back with a highly requested video about how to get into UCLA. I hope this video is helpful for high schoolers or even those middle schoolers who are starting early. These are my tips on how to maximize your chances of getting into UCLA, and they're based on my personal experience and observation. I filmed this video in collaboration with my friend Aaron, who also has some tips to offer, so be sure to check out his video. Let's begin and get into the first step, which is your mindset. So the first tip that I have about mindset is to simply decide. Look at your options and evaluate your goals early on, make a decision, and stick to it. If you want to get into UCLA or a top college, which I'm assuming you're kind of interested in because you're at this video, then make that decision, respect it, and stick to it as you go through the rest of your high school journey. So my next mindset tip is to incorporate a bit of an all or nothing perspective. So I just told myself that I had no backup plan, so as I went through high school, I had to give it my all and work as if there was nothing waiting behind me. But the important thing is that you should actually, in the back of your mind, keep an open perspective, because at the end of the day, there are so many different options. And literally right after I submitted my college applications, I just went back to like throwing my hands up and knowing that I'd be happy with my future even if I didn't get to any college at all. But for the time being, it really helps me to kind of just drill that perspective. So my next tip for mindset is to give yourself visual reminders. So when I was in high school, I framed a meaningful postcard that I had written to my future self, and each quarter I would print out my report card in a tiny version and put it into the frame. As I was studying, I would see the accumulation of each quarter's grades add up, and it gave me like a constant visual reminder to be trying my best and not disappointing myself. So other things that you could do is like stick a picture of UCLA onto your planner or inside your planner, or even put it as your lock screen background, which is what my little sister does. The next mindset tip is to prioritize and time things correctly. I really believe in working hard and playing hard. I still wanted to enjoy my time in high school with my friends and family. A rule like the Pareto principle or the 80-20 rule really comes into play here. It basically says that 80% of your results come from 20% of your efforts. So optimize, be efficient, and don't try to do everything. Do the important things on time and to the best of your ability. So now we're going to move into the next category, which is kind of the basics and the academic side. I think that GPA and SAT or ACT are definitely the benchmarks. So you do need to get a certain score to be in the safe zone or to really like maximize your chances of having your application getting looked at. I'll put like kind of the general scores in the caption down below because I don't know them off the top of my head. But definitely try all 4 years, but don't freak out if you mess up, because you do have the chance to explain in your comment app the reasons behind it. For those of you who are freaking out because you messed up freshman year, don't worry, because I think I am like the poster child example of someone who messed up freshman year. My GPA was actually a 2.8, like I'm not joking. But after that, I kind of decided to work really hard, and when I was applying to UCLA, I was applying with a weighted 4 GPA, a 4.38 unweighted GPA, SAT score of 2200, which I took 2 times, then I applied with 4 AP tests and 3 SAT2 subject tests. My grades and SAT score were kind of in that safe or optimal range for UCLA admissions. So definitely spend some time just making sure you're putting your best effort for grades and your SAT or ACT preparation. I don't want to talk about the academic part too much because I know there's plenty of information online and in other videos, but my last tip would be to take AP classes and really work hard during your AP classes, because ultimately you do get graded on those. Some of the material comes up on SATs, and they definitely come up in subject tests and AP tests, which you want to do well in, because I think when you see admissions see that you've already knocked out a lot of potential coursework towards majors, they're more willing to take you in as a student because you're kind of seen as less risky and you're kind of seen as having made some progress already on your way to getting a degree. So I would definitely recommend to take AP classes and do well in them. So the last category that I wanted to go over is the application itself. So my first tip for the application is to start thinking about it early on. One thing that really helped me was to make a running list of accomplishments as I was going through high school, and I would write a short paragraph about how I felt when I achieved that accomplishment or milestone and how I learned from it. So when I was going to actually write my essay, it was super helpful because I had a document of all these past experiences to pull back on and to refresh my memory. So to briefly go over the Common app, I would just say get to know it really well, check it out as soon as the portal opens up, and when it asks you to fill things out, fill it out as much as you can. If it asks you to put 10, like a maximum of 10 things, try to put 10 things if you can. Don't leave things out, just throw it all on there. The more information, the better. So now let's talk a bit about the essay. This essay is about you. It's also about them, but it's mostly about you. They know who they are and they know what kind of student they're looking for, so you don't want to spend your essay just repeating their search query back to them. I would say for the UC essays, make it memorable and make it personal because they're going through so many and you really want yours to be impressionable. For mine, for example, I wrote about how I grew up in Shanghai without my parents and how, in a sense, the city raised me. So in the future, I ultimately want to go back and be able to contribute to the city as like a greater person. And in the very last paragraph, I kind of tied in some of my high school accomplishments. I really wrote about something that was unique to me and I really focused on letting my character traits show through the essay. So then when you've written your essay, I think it's a good idea to seek out help and other opinions. So you do have to take a little bit of a risk if you're going to write about something personal in your essay, but I think it's good to get like a very broad general opinion from someone else just to make sure that your essay doesn't come off too strong to the point that it might hurt your chances. So I would definitely advise like having a few people just read it over and make sure that it's generally okay and doesn't run the risk of offending anyone or throwing anyone too off guard. The very last thing about the application that I want to talk about is the superstar effect versus the well-rounded effect. And I personally think being well-rounded is more important when you're trying to apply to a school like UCLA, because given the format of UCLA's coursework, I think they kind of prefer students who show that they can handle or excel at whatever is thrown at them versus someone who's very good at a specific field or topic. If you're one of the latter students, you might be better off looking at private schools that might have more tailored programs. Well, for me during high school, I pretty much had a mix of extracurriculars, which included running a fashion blog, co-founding a website-based startup, and doing speech and debate. Okay, so those are some of the top tips that helped me when I was going through the process of applying to UCLA that I wanted to share with you guys. Remember that it's important to first have the right mindset, then to secure your basic academic benchmarks, then lastly to curate an impressionable yet well-rounded application. And be sure to check out my friend Erin's video for more tips. So I hope that you can apply some of our tips to your high school journey. And I wish you the best of luck to all the colleges that you may apply to, and especially to UCLA. As always, feel free to leave questions or comments down below, and check out and subscribe for some of my other UCLA videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They never